the African capital reps here present, Nana Sao. I guess you're from Ghana, right? The representative of Ancon and Nabo. When you were speaking, I thought you were from Cross River State. I'm sure you probably live there for your name, I know where you come from. My friend and brother, the chairman of PETAN, Nicolas Odinuwe, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, let me start with Ancon. Usually in this part of the world, when you hear that Ancon has taken over a company, it is like death sentence, that company is gone. That is what you hear and that is what we know currently. I don't know anybody who knows otherwise. Every company that is sealed by Ancon, people are looking forward when they will list it for sale. And then to crown it all, they then appointed the chairman of Dorman Long, who is a lawyer. If I were in Dorman Long, that would be the zenith of my fright. Because you're in Ancon, they bring in a lawyer to chair you. What's on your mind is liquidation process. But today, it is a different story. And we're here, and I think Ancon should be proud of it, that what you do to save public funds is not about taking from Peter to sell to Paul. What is that? If there is good corporate governance in any organization that you go in to want to revive, you are sure to work with that organization to see them come out of your, if you like, clutches. So thank you very much for what you have done with Dorman Long. When Timi was speaking, not too many people know that Timi is a lawyer. And he took on Dorman Long in 2014. I was one of those who were a bit skeptical when Timi took it over. He came in, met me the first time and said, look, he's a lawyer. We made the chairman of Dorman Long to revive the company. I didn't believe it because I know in my days in Shell, once they bring lawyers, they have two characteristics. It's either they come and cause trouble or they come and close the trouble. So I didn't believe it. But today, the story is different. Dorman Long, like he said, in terms of evolution, why you have to evolve as a business. For those of us who remember the first Niger Bridge, because we're talking about first now because there is a second, and that was all steel structure built by Dorman Long. Today, the second Niger Bridge is under construction. It is a concrete bridge, so it has evolved. So if Dorman Long had remained building steel bridges, by now they would have fizzled out. I am one of those who look forward to celebrating 100 years of Dorman Long, just like you see on CNN where they celebrate companies that have survived for 100 years. It will be a pride for us as a country that at least, I don't know of too many companies that have survived for 100 years in Nigeria. And this takes dexterity, focus, and continuous evolution of the business of that company. So I look forward to that, and I pray we are all alive to celebrate 100 years of Dorman Long, so that we'll enter into the Fortune 500 book or 100 as those companies that survived. I think the other organization to focus on is also PETAN. I see a different dynamics in the activities of PETAN for the past couple of years. Now they are gotten into the space of promoting their own. Hitherto, everybody was doing in a dog-eat-dog situation to grab the opportunity that is available. But I see a different paradigm for the past 2 years of saying, we have to promote our own. We have to talk about the capacity that we have created in country At times I look at the Instagram page, I see them promoting their own company. This has never happened. It was all man for himself, God for all of us. That is what I saw. So I must commend PETAN that you must continue in this trajectory, because if anybody thinks that my job is easy, you're making a big mistake. The headwind that I face as a person in trying to push Nigerian capability in the oil and gas industry is even more than the tornado that America faces every other day. The same Nigerians that are in the international oil companies stand against Nigerians participating in those businesses, which is very sad. And they do this with all impunity. But the beauty of it all is when they retire, they come through the door and say, ah, SDMU, you have to protect our company. And I look at them and I laugh. On a continuous basis, in most of the companies, you have those Nigerians whose motive are driven by something else. Not about believing in the country, not about creating employment opportunity, not about adding value. It's all about expatriation. It's all about taking needed foreign exchange out of this country. Look at the statistics shared by NQ. Dorman Long employed 400 Nigerians. Multiply that by four. Put in an average family of four. That is 1,600 direct impact on families. Add another 1,000 in extended family scenario. You're looking at 2,600 people benefiting from a company. Today, the population of Nigeria is growing astronomically. And if we don't do anything different, we all one day will not be around to enjoy whatever hard work we put in this country. Therefore, we must do everything we can to believe in Nigeria, dream Nigeria, and encourage Nigerian businesses to continue to flourish. Most often than not, we think that China started yesterday. It didn't. They went through a process. Today, they are an economy to reckon with. Germany, after the Second World War, had nothing. With the introduction of the Marshall Law by the Americans, and the Germans then looked inwards. Today, technologically, they are pushing the boundaries to ensure that it is their businesses that come to Nigeria to deliver services. Local content does not matter to them. Will you blame them? Of course not, because the definition, primary, if you like, pedestal definition of capitalism is the exploitation of man for the benefit of man. So any capitalist world that believes in it is to exploit Africa for the benefit of Europe or for the benefit of America. So we all have to understand the reason why we must create value in country, create jobs in country. Look at the demographics, look at the youth population, look at our investment in research and development. 3 days ago, I gave the statistics of the investment that developed countries make on research and statistics. About 63% of research funding in the world belongs to five countries: USA, China, Germany, Japan, just to mention, plus India. And these five countries control 50% of the world's GDP. Is there no nexus or correlation to that? But for us as a country, we must continue to believe in what we have. Today, I come across projects where we say Dorman Long has built capacity, recapitalized, and can do more. I get a headwind from the IOCs, managed by Nigerians, saying, no, we should take this job out of the country in order for people to execute. The sorry state is that even the indigenous Nigerian companies are the biggest culprits who want to take jobs out. country. Application of local content is not one size fits all. It's not at all costs. We have capacity enough to evaluate in a pragmatic way what is possible and what is not possible. All we do is just push the boundaries a bit to continue to build local capacity. Nobody believed us when we said we wanted to integrate the biggest FPSO in the world today in Lagos. The opposition to it knew no bounds. Today, we are proud to say that the Engr FPSO, 200,000 barrels per day production, was integrated here in Lagos, and 6 of the 12 modules were fabricated here in Lagos. That is dreaming and wanting to create jobs. During that process, we had about 4,000 Nigerian welders participating in that project. But today, all we get is serious resistance from our own Nigerians who should believe in it. But we will not give up because we have an assignment and we will continue to push the boundaries. So once again, I thank the African Capital for coming to rescue a company that we are all proud of. Dorman Long has been involved in so many projects, ranging from offshore, onshore, and shallow offshore in the country, and their capacity keep growing as we speak. So today I'm happy. It's one of those success stories that I will continue to share, that the focus on it, we have deliberately ensured that Dorman Long got jobs that are equal to their capacity to deliver to the oil and gas industry. Hence, why this success today. Hence, why we are sitting here. Hence, why the investors are able to come, because they've seen it. They've seen the funnel, they've seen the project opportunity, they've seen the capability, and most importantly, they have seen the Nigerian Content Act, which serves as a protection for people who build capacity in country. So, without further ado, I congratulate Timmy Austin Peters and the entire staff of Dorman Long. It is your commitment, your dedication, and your belief in this country that has led Dorman Long to achieve this feat. And I think the sky is the limit. If we continue to practice corporate governance in the way it should be, then this company will survive for another 70 years. Thank you very much.